Here we go with more questions and answers and some useful information from our viewers. So let's see what we could learn today. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And we have a lot of questions and even more answers in this Q&A session. But before we get to that, I want to say thank you to everyone who has contributed on Patreon and on PayPal Me. I'll have their names listed right over here. That's a big thank you to all of you. These videos would not be possible without your contribution. Now let's get to the Q&A here. I did a series of videos on the Raspberri Pi and DCC++ and JMRI, and a lot of these questions and answers pertain to that. There's a few more that are on older videos. But the first one is from Guzi Alpha. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. How do you configure the resolution with the Raspberri Pi? Now, I did a video using the VNC, and I showed a little bit on there about how to do it. To change the resolution on the Raspberri Pi, I have this connected up to the VNC right now, so we'll just go over here to the main menu, go down to preferences, and see Raspberri Pi configuration. And when you bring that up, resolution, you could set your resolution in here. And in this drop down, see, I have it set as 1280 to 720 by 720. You have all of these available. Now the default on here is 720 by 480, which makes things really big to be able to see all the menus in there, the very top of the menus. I had to change it to 1280 by 720. Okay, this one's from Russ Ratzman. Where do you get the motor shields for the DCC++? Everybody's been out of stock of the good motor shields except for Palulu. I'll give you the link for Palulu in the description. But Arduino now has the motor shields back in stock. They're $22 US. So you can get them there. I've been reading up on users claiming that they were able to use the DF robot motor shield for DCC++. I've been reading into it a little bit. I went and ordered one. It's only $16.50 from DF robot. From the description, it looks like they use the same pins as the Arduino motor shield for the PWM and the output to the motors. So I think that one will work. Now the other one was Deke Robot. Now I had a couple of people tell me that they got it and they used it. Even back then when I had this comment about 4 months ago, I told them that they had the 293 instead of the 298. 293 is less amperage, but both of them claimed that they had the 298. I couldn't even find it on the Deke Robot back then or now. They only list one, and that's the 293 chip. But Palulu, Arduino, Deke Robot with a reduced amperage, and I'm going to be testing out the DF Robot one pretty soon, as soon as I get it in. Troy Simpson. Can the Raspberri Pi do no keyboard and monitor like the Pi Sprague? I wasn't familiar with what the Pi Sprague could do, but I went and checked into it. And from what I learned since then, that, and this will come up in a couple of other questions, yes, you can do that without a keyboard, without a mouse, and without a monitor. I use VNC to hook up my tablet so I can operate it. You can also start JMRI when the Raspberri Pi boots up, and I'll do a video on that coming up pretty shortly. I have a follow-up question on, or a follow-up comment on that. I'll leave that one for last. That's the real good one with the good, really good information on it. Okay, the next one is Mike Peterson, how many trains can be run on DCC++? And what I told him, on the Arduino motor shield, it's rated at 2 amps. The Pululu motor shield has one rated at 3 amps, one rated at 5 amps per channel. Regular DCC, they have systems that run at 3 amps, at 5 amps, and you could get boosters adding on to that. There's a lot of factors involved. I'm right here. I got my Y throttle set up. I got my DCC on the Raspberri Pi. I just updated engine driver on here, so I got a new icon on there. So we'll open that up and we'll bring up Leak and Creek. We'll select, and I don't have an address on this one yet, so I'll just put in 3, come down here, acquire, just to make sure we have it. There we go. Okay, so we're going to go in forward. Now we're going to watch over here. If I turn the Wii throttle off, let's just turn it off right here and we can watch the amperage. Okay, so you can see the amperage drops down as soon as we turn it on. We have 0.09. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this forward, but I'm going to hold it. And we're going to see how many amps it draws. Right now it's at 0.10. So we're going to go bring it up to about 20, and I'm holding it, and see, we got about 0.21. I'll just put a little bit of pressure up on the top, say maybe 0.25 an amp at the most. So if you had 4 locomotives like that running with a load on it, you're only going to be drawing about 1 amp. So I'd say you could easily run 8 locomotives on there and still be within your limit of 2 amps on this Raspberri Pi right here on the motor shield. I have it set at 12 volts. Usually you would set your HO scale on DCC to about 16. Well, this ranges from 7 to 12 volts. You could go up to 18 volts safely. Let's go up to 16 volts on here. Okay, we got 16 volts, 0.08 to begin with, and let's crank this up. We'll go up to 20 or 24. 20. So slightly less, 0.2. At the most, and let's put a little bit of pressure on the top of it. Okay, so 0.2. So I would say if you wanted to be on the safe side, I would get the Pululu, which could handle the 3 amps, plus it can go up a higher voltage on it. This, on the specs, this says 7 to 12 volts on the motor side, but it says you could push it all the way up to 18. I don't really like to push it. I mean, I can if I want to, and you could still run 8 locomotives on it easily. James Smith. Okay, this is one I did on the scale where I used my cell phone as a reference to calibrate the scale. Okay. He says, use a brand new nickel, it's 5 grams. And I said, thank you. And what's a good idea is whenever you're calibrate or whenever you're doing a reference for a scale, it's a good idea to do a low reference and a high reference. George Gilliam. Now he really didn't say what kind of problem he was having. He says the DF player won't work. Okay, well, I said, well, if you're referring to the easy sound effects, he wanted me to send him a diagram. I says, there is a reference in the description, like whenever I do a video that has some technical information in there, I always put a link in the description for whatever I'm doing. I have a link to my website on there where I have Arduino Made Easy and Arduino Projects. So you could always reference it there, and you could always reference, go down in the description and see if there's a reference in there for whatever project I'm doing. All right, Joe G has two of them. Can you use DCC++ for just programming with another system? Yes, you can. You could use it for just programming, and it's really good at programming, like I did on my first video with it. It does it better than what I had set up for my Digitrax, because with my Digitrax going through the PR3 and doing it on JMRI, trying to program something, it was real slow. But with the DCC++ setup program track, you don't need the PR3. You hook it straight up to it, and when you program, da 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 da, it goes right down the line. So it's really fast. Yes, you could use it that way. And I would prefer programming with the DCC++ rather than trying to do it with the throttle with the PR3, or even through the JMRI with the PR3, because the DCC++ is a lot faster, a lot more reliable. Okay, his second problem, he's trying to get into the DCC++. He bought himself a new Arduino Uno, a generic one, and a generic motor shield too. Anyway, he asked me the question. He bought an Uno R3 at Mega 328A with a CH340 chipset in it. And he says every time he plugs in the USB, it crashes his computer. And I told him to go back and look on the page where he bought it to see if they have a driver for that particular one, because the CH340 chipset is different than the regular Uno. I had the same problem when I had the Nano. I had to get a driver for one of my computers. I think my older computer, my computer that had the Windows 10 didn't have a problem reading it, but my older computer with Windows 7 on it, I had to get the driver for the CH340 chipset. And he wrote back and he says that did the trick. Okay, now my last one is a comment with really good, useful information. It goes back to Troy Simpson's, can you do without the keyboard, the mouse and the monitor, like on the Sprog, just boot up and go directly to your throttle? Now, this is from Steve Todd. Now, when I first looked at the name, I didn't really recognize it until he started talking a little bit on the comments. He's the gentleman that wrote the engine driver app. And he has, on his webpage, he has a pre-configured image for the Raspberri Pi that will work with JMRI and any DCC system you have, even DCC++. He has it configured that it will check for whatever system you have. And within a few minutes, you'll be able to use your cell phone as a throttle with that system. And I'll put the link in the description here for everyone to see. He says they use it at his club and it works well. They just turn the power on and within a few minutes everybody is using their throttle for that system. So that's what I have. I think that was 9 comments, questions, and information there. Coming up, I've been working on this. I've been doing a little bit of painting on this, and I got it to look a little bit better than, you know, what it looks like out of the box. And this is almost finished. I have to do a little bit more weathering on it, and I had an issue with it, and I'm going to show you in a short video coming up sometime this week. And also, I'm showing that on one of the Model Railroading for Beginners on how to do that. So, that's all we have for right now. So, until the next time, we'll see ya. Here's my list for today. It's not going to take that long unless I start rambling.